everyone, and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered that how to install Python, and we have also installed some packages using Python. In our today's session, we will be talking about how we can display websites in Chrome. So guys, I'm not talking about searching any website in Chrome, but if you want to see its HTML, how we can view the HTML of any website on Chrome, how we can understand the data inside it. So we will be learning that. Here we do not have to go on the core of HTML. We just need to understand a little bit of HTML. For that also, we have some upcoming videos in which I will be teaching you about the tags and attributes, but those are different things. So as of now, we will just understand that how we can display the website in our Chrome. So to display a website in our Chrome, let's move to our Chrome. And I already have this Amazon's website opened over here. So you can just open randomly anything, any page. For example, you can open electronics and you can search for anything. I'll just go with this one only. So let's go ahead with this page only. If I want to view the HTML of this page, all I need to do is press right click here, right click and click on inspect. So as soon as you'll click on inspect, a window like this will appear. Now here you can choose the view. So if you want to keep it at the bottom, you can keep it at the bottom. On the right hand side, you can see we have three dots. And if we just click on any of them, suppose I wanted to go on the right hand side. So I'll just choose it like this. So this thing will go on the right hand side. Our page will look like this. It will become a little bit compressed here, but on the right, we'll get the HTML. And as you can see, we have the HTML of this page. So if you have heard about HTML, the HTML starts with the HTML tag. So here it's starting with the HTML tag. And then we have different things here. So as also you can see, as I'm moving my cursor here, something is happening on the window. Something is getting highlighted. So what are these things that are getting highlighted? So if I talk about this, so you can see the Amazon's icon is highlighted over here. And let's move down a little bit. And if you want to just, you know, find the code related to anything on this page, all you need to do is on this navigation bar on the top, we have this square like thing and this arrow. All you need to do is click on this and then go to any product. So suppose if I go to headphones here, as you can see, the string, that means the code related to it, is being displayed over here. It has images, and here we have the source file as well. So source file is basically SRC is basically a source file which we provide over here. So we have a source file, and if I move a bit down, and you know, just let's choose the navigation bar again. And if I have this one, if I want to check for its string, so here we have the string, which is in our white color, that is fitness trackers and smartwatches. So this is the string here. So we'll be going in the details of this HTML later, but we will be not going for the core HTML, but we will not be learning that how this thing is being created, like how we have created a string here, or how we have created these tags here, how we have added an image in this source files, or we have added the links in href. So we will not be going in depth here, but we will be just understanding that what is this a tag, what is this href, what is this fitness trackers and smartwatches, which you can clearly understand that it is a string here. What is this class? This class is not similar to our Python class, but yeah, kind of similar, but not exactly similar. What is this li and other things? So we will be understanding this in our upcoming sessions. But as of now, you can see this is how we can display any website. And if I open a new tab and I'll write WsCube Tech courses, and let's go here. So we have this WsCubeTech.com. That means we have our website here. And you can look for anything, like you can go for courses for students. Let's click on this, and we have different categories over here. And you can just inspect anything and view anything. So I'll just scroll down and let's go for this Python certification course in English. Let's click on this. Let me right click on it and we'll click on inspect. As soon as I'll click on inspect, this thing will appear. And here we have the HTML code for this page. If you want to choose anything for again, then we will be going to our navigation bar, and here there's an image. And then here we have a string. You can see the string related to this. That means the code related to this has appeared on here on the right hand side. That is Python certification course. And again, if I go to our navigation bar, let's scroll down, and you can see things related to it is being appeared basically here. Okay, so you can see some LI is over here. These are basically list items, and if I open this, you can see inside this we have accessible on mobile phone. If I click on this one, this says highly experienced faculty for this course. If I open this one, this says top quality test after every session. Interview preparation. This one says total 250 plus top rated MCQs, and everything that is written on basically on our web page is here on our HTML. So all you need to do is just view this inside the HTML. Now, why do we need to view this? Because later what we will be doing with the help of our libraries that we are going to use here in Python, we will be obtaining this HTML code, and from this HTML code only we will be extracting this data. That's why to view a HTML code is important here. So this is how you can view any website using the inspect method. And that is it for this video. In our next video, we will be talking about our request library, that how does this request library work. Also, in the further upcoming videos, I'll be teaching you about a little bit of HTML. So not exactly how to create it, but in this HTML page, so just like how we have inspected this page and what all things we saw over here, some, you know, brackets, some classes, some different things are there. So I'll be just teaching you what all basic things are there that you need to understand in order to retrieve the data, and that's all. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session where we will be understanding about request library. Thank you.